Dear students, welcome to the online classes of chemistry. So here today we are going to discuss the charge and mass of proton. The charge and mass of proton. Look here, students. Charge and mass of proton. The charge and mass of the proton. So here, when hydrogen gas is taken in the discharge tube, the positively charged particles are produced, and the positively charged particles, these are having a maximum of E by M value. So these are having, that is, so E by M value, that is maximum, and these are called as, these positively charged particles are called as protons. And it was named by a scientist called as Rutherford in 1911. Look here, students. 1911 ರಲ್ಲಿ Rutherford ಅಂತಕಂತ ಸೈಂಟಿಸ್ಟ್ ಒಂದು ಡಿಸ್ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ತಗೊಂಡ, ಹೈಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿದ, ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಅನ್ನು ಲೋ ಮಾಡಿದ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಎಚ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ಗಳು ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆದವು. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇದರದ್ದು ಇ ಬೈ ಎಂ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಏನದಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ಅದ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಸೊ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನದ, ಸೊ Rutherford ಈ ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್ ಅದ, ಈ ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್ಗೆ ಏನದಲ್ಲ, ತಾನು ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್ ಅಂತಿಕೊಂಡು ಹೆಸರಿಟ್ಟ ಇವಾಗೆಲ್ಲ, ರೀತಿ ಎಚ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್ಗಳು ಬಂದು ಇವಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೆಸರಿಟ್ಟ. ಅದು 1911. 1886 ಒಳಗೆ ಏನದಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ರೇಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎನೋಡ್ ರೇಸ್ ಅಂತಿಕೊಂಡು ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಬರ್ತಿರ್ತಾವ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಇಲ್ಲಿ, ಸೊ ಫೈನ್ hydrogen gas is enclosed in a discharge tube. Hydrogen gas ana thonu tilri enclosed in a discharge tube. The positively charged particles, the positively charged particles, right? So positively charged particles of maximum E by M. So it is, that is charge to mass ratio, the ratio of charge to, that is mass, E by M maximum, that is E by M are produced. So it is here we are produced. So here these particles, these are positively charged particles, and these are called as protons, and it was named by Rutherford in 1911. So it is produced. These positively charged particles, these positively charged particles, these positively charged particles are called, these positively charged particles are called, so these are, the positively charged particles are called as protons. The positively charged particles are called protons. Remember this. ಇವುಗಳಿಗೆ ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೆಸರಿಟ್ಟರು. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಸ್ ನೇಮ್ಡ್ ಬೈ Rutherford in 1911. So it is in 1911. It is like this. Look here. Hydrogen, he has taken in the discharge tube and it loses electron. So then it forms, that is H plus ions. So here, that is when this, that is H plus ions, when high potential is applied, so it loses electron and it forms proton. It is called as proton. So it was named by Rutherford in 1911. So here, what is the charge and mass? What is the charge and mass? So here, number one, the mass of the proton, the mass of the proton is here. Remember, the mass of the proton is 1.6726 into 10^-27 kg. Look here, students. It is, so it is 1.6726 into 10^-27 kg.
So it is here, it is mass.
And what is its charge? Exactly opposite to that of an electron.
So it is the charge of the proton is minus 1.6022 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb.
Look here.
So it is plus. For electron it is minus. For proton it is plus 1.6022 into 10 raised to, that is minus 19 coulomb. So remember this. This is the charge and mass. ಇದು ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಮತ್ತು ಮಾಸ್. 1.6726 ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಬುಕ್ದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನದಲ್ಲ, ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಬುಕ್ದಲ್ಲಿ 1.673 ಬರೀತಾನೆ, ಬರೆದ್ರು ಬರ್ತದೆ 1.673 ಬರೆದ್ರು ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ 10⁻²⁷ ಕೆ ಜಿ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಸರಿ ಗ್ರಾಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಗ್ರಾಮದಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ತಗೋತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದೆನ್ ಪಡಬೇಕು. ಇದು ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್. ಸೊ ದ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ 1.6726 ಇಂಟು 10⁻²⁷ ಕೆ ಜಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ 1.6022 ಇಂಟು 10⁻⁹⁹ ಕೂಲಂಬ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಯೂನಿ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್ಸ್. ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ನೇಮ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ರದರ್ಫೋರ್ಡ್. ದೆನ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕವರಿ ಆಫ್ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಾನ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಸಬ್ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್. So up to this that we studied two subatomic particle, and after this that is another third one subatomic particle. So that is called as a neutron. Then look here. Discovery of neutron. Discovery of neutron. Remember students, in 1932, a scientist called as James Chadwick discovered the new particle that is called as neutron, the new particle called the neutron. So he bombarded the alpha particles, the source of alpha particles, to the beryllium foil or beryllium plate, and then neutrons are produced. So in 1932 olaga James Chadwick anta scientist alpha ray particles galanna beryllium plate ge enadalli dikki hodisida. ಸೊ ಬೆರಿಲಿಯಂ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಗೆ ಡಿಕ್ಕಿ ಹೊಡಿಸಿದಗಳಿಗೆ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಫಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಜೊತೆ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗಿ ಬೆರಿಲಿಯಂ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೆರಿಲಿಯಂ, ಇಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಶೋ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡೈ. ಲುಕ್ ಹಿಯರ್, source of alpha particles, beryllium foil here it is green. Look here, when alpha particles so hit to this beryllium foil, so therefore here the neutrons are ejected. So these are called as neutrons. So it is a diagram. Diagram is not necessary, but here that is to understand this. I draw a diagram here. So that is the source of alpha particles, and then it is the beryllium plate or beryllium foil. And when alpha particle hit to the beryllium foil, so it produces neutron. And neutrons are that is the neutrons are that is hit to the screen. So screen maybe that is of paraffin wax, or that is any other that is the screen is taken here. Look here. This is called as that is how these neutrons are produced. Look here. In 1932. James Chadwick discovered a new particle called a neutron. So it is a new particle called a neutron.
Adakke neutron antha hesarita.
So it is when he bombarded this beryllium foil. So it is, he bombarded a thin beryllium foil with alpha particles. Neutrons were produced.
Look here, students. Beryllium foil with alpha particles. So it is here the neutrons were produced.
In 1932, James Chadwick discovered a new particle called a neutron when he bombarded a thin beryllium foil with alpha particles. Neutrons were produced. So these alpha particles, when bombarded with this beryllium foil, and then it produces neutron. So the reaction is like this. Look here. So it is, I will write that is this beryllium like this. So beryllium, it is 4, it is 9, plus that is alpha particles. So helium is the source of alpha particle. So it is alpha particle. So it is 2, it is 4. You may write 9 this side also. You may write 4 this side also. Then it produces carbon 12, 6 plus. Look here, students. 9 plus 4 it is 13, 4 plus 2 it is 6, 12 plus 1 13 it is 6, so it is a neutron. This is called as a neutron. So these particles are not deflected in the electric and magnetic field because these are neutral. ಇವು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಮತ್ತು ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಡಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯು, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಲ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಜೀರೋ, ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಜೀರೋ, ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಎ ಮಾಸ್ ಸ್ಲೈಟ್ಲಿ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ ದಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಿಯರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ 1.675, ಸೇಮ್ 1.673, 1.675 ಇಂಟು 10⁻²⁷ ಕೆಜಿ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದೀಸ್ particles, means that is neutron, these particles, so it is these particles were not deflected by electric and magnetic field. So these are not deflected, indicating that these are neutral. So indicating that these are neutral. So you neutral ಅದು ಅಂತ ಇರೋದಲ್ಲ indicate ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. So it is, these are neutral and are called as neutrons. Look here, students. It is about a neutron. So it is when
the beryllium foil or beryllium plate is bombarded with, here there is this alpha ray particle source, so it produces a neutron. So it is here, it produces neutron, and then that is, these are not deflected in the electric and magnetic field, means these are neutral and the charge is considered to be zero. It has only mass. So therefore, here that is the mass of this look here. Neutron has zero charge. So it is here, it does not have any charge. And its mass is found to be 1.675. Look here, students. 1.675 into 10 raised to minus 47 kg. 1.675 into 10 raised to minus 27 kg. So it is a neutral. It is a neutral. It is neutral. And is represented as like this. It is represented as this. So this neutron is present in the nucleus of an atom. Neutron is present in the nucleus of an atom. Nucleus of an atom. Look here, it is about this neutrons. Now let us see that is it. So we know that about the fundamental particles now. We know that is electron, we know the proton, and we know the neutron. So all the we studied about all the three fundamental particles. Ella moodu fundamental particles atho subatomic particle bagiyano tilkondivige. So it is avugalanna sankshiptavagi hege represent madu, how they can be represented briefly. So it is how they can be represented briefly. So it is, let us see. Here, neutron has zero charge, no charge, it is a neutral. Its mass is found to be 1.675 × 10⁻²⁷ that is kg. It is a neutral and it is represented by, that is N. So it is, I have given symbolically, the neutron is present in the nucleus of an atom. We know that. So nucleus contains neutron and proton. And outside of the nucleus, the electrons are revolving around the nucleus. Now, look here, students. Name of subatomic particle. So it is, you know that is name, it's a symbol, a symbol, and you may write that is the third one, that is a red, that is a absolute charge. It is per coulomb, absolute charge, it is a per coulomb, and then relative charge. Relative charge, we will write that is relative charge also. So it is, and then that is mass per kg. So mass of the subatomic particle, it may be also written as that is mass in terms of kg. Mass in terms of kg, and you will write that is approximate mass. Approximate mass. So it is approximate mass.
So it is here. Look here, students. So name of the subatomic particle first. Here we will go that is in the sequence that is electron, proton, and neutron. Electron, proton, and neutron. Look here. And here we know the symbol. Electron is represented by, in some book it is written as E, so that is superscript minus sign, and then it is proton, so it is a P, and then it is a neutron N. Is not necessary to represent that is 0, 1 like this, or that is here 1, and then that is minus 1 like this. So it is, what is the absolute charge? It is minus 1.6022 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulombs. We know it. And same that is proton plus 1.6022 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulombs. It is plus. And then that is it has zero mass. Look here, student, it is zero. So then what is the relative charge? Relative means that is generally minus 1 plus 1 and it is 0. It is minus 1 plus 1, 0. Then what is mass per kg? So it is 9.109 into 10 raised to minus 31, it is in terms of kg. 9.109 into 10 raised to minus 31, that is kg. It is 1.672, 6 into 10 raised to minus 27 kg. It is 1.673 into 10 raised to minus 27 kg. Look here. It is about this that is mass per kg. So it is, you may also write that is this approximate mass, or that is mass that is here, mass in kg, and then that is approximate mass that is in AMU also. So it is mass in unified unit. You may also write mass in unified unit. Mass per unified unit. That is AMU, atomic mass unit. Atomic mass unit. So it is here you may also write absolute mass in kg. So it is mass in kg. So then here it is 0.0054. It is 0.0054. So then that is it is 1.00. Look here. It is in AMU, it is 1.00727. And it is near to that is more than this, that is 1.00867. Okay. It is about this, that is mass in unified units. So you may also write that is approximate 0, and then that is 1, 1, 1 like this also. So then who discovered this? So it is first one that is discovered by, electron is discovered by electron was discovered by, so it is what is his name? So that is electron is discovered by J.J. Thomson. J.J. Thomson, and then that is this proton. So it is actually that is the positively charged particle where that is given by Rutherford. So it is here, it is given by Rutherford. Rutherford. And the third one is James Chadwick. So it is about this, that is the brief, that is the introduction regarding this. So how the electron, proton and neutrons are having that is charges, and then that is absolute charge, and then that is mass per kg, and that is in AMU, that is called as a atomic mass unit. So students, that is after this, that is when the charge, when it is discovered, the subatomic particles were discovered. So therefore, that is this Thomson and other scientists, that is worked on the atomic model. J.J. Thomson, he is thinking that how these charges are distributed in an atom. So therefore, different, that is atomic models were proposed by different scientists to explain the distribution of these charged particles.
to explain the distribution of these charged particles. But only that is two that is model where that is explained. So it is one is given by J.J. Thomson and another one is given by Rutherford. So ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಸೈಂಟಿಸ್ಟ್ ಗಳು ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಡೆಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟರು. ಸೊ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಗಳನ್ನ ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಕೊಟ್ಟರಲ್ಲಿ. ಆದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಇಬ್ಬರದ್ದು ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಕೊಟ್ಟರು, ಒಂದು ರುದರ್ಫೋರ್ಡ್ ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಜೆ ಜೆ ಥಾಮ್ಸನ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸೀ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಡೆಲ್.
Atomic model.
So atomic model, remember different atomic models were proposed to explain the distribution of these charged particles. ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಮಾಡೆಲ್ ಗಳನ್ನು ತೀತು ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಸ್ಟ್ ಗಳು ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಡೆಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟರು. ಹೌ ದೀಸ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್, ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್ ಗಳನ್ನ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತಕೊಂಡಿರೋದೆಲ್ಲ ಕೊಟ್ಟರು. ಆದ್ರೆ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೂ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೂ ಆಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಮಾಡೆಲ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೈ ಜೆ ಜೆ ಥಾಮ್ಸನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೈ ರುದರ್ಫೋರ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇವು ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಎರಡು ಥಿಯರಿಗಳು. So then Thomson's model of an atom in his law. Number one. Look here, sir. Thomson's model of an atom in his law. So the Thomson's model of an atom really. Look here. This is a spherical shape. This is an atom. ಈ ಐಟಮ್ ದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಇದ್ರದ್ದು ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಇದು ರೆಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಅದೇ. ಸೊ ಇದು ರೆಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಏನದಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇದು ಐಟಮ್. ಇದು ರೆಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಏನದಲ್ಲ red part, so it indicates the red part that is indicates the positive charge particles. So it is positive sphere is a red part, positive sphere red part positive sphere, or that is red part gives that is a positive part, positively charged particles take positive sphere. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇದ್ರೊಳಗೆ ಏನದಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್. ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್. And here the size of the atom is, so it is its sphere, that the size of this atom is, so it is nearly that is 10^-10 meter and its nucleus is 10^-15 meter. So idu atomic model nalli yen helida, look here. So it is in 1898 J.J. Thomson proposed an atom. And he explained that, so here the atom is a spherical shape. Atom is a spherical shape. So its radius is 10^-10 meter. Its radius, atom's radius is 10^-10 meter. And the nucleus, that is, nucleus has radius 10^-15 meter. Look here, students. Atom has radius 10^-10 meter
and the nucleus has that is radius 10 to minus 15 meter. 10 to 15 meter. And here, in which the positive charge is uniformly distributed. The positive charge is uniformly distributed throughout the atom. Positive charge ಏನದಲ್ಲ uniformly distributed ಆಗಿದೆ. And the electrons are embedded. Electrons are embedded. Electrons ಗಳೇನದಲ್ಲ ಚುಚ್ಚಿದಂಗೆ ಇರ್ತಾವು. Embedded into it. So it is, yeah, that is here. They are given different names. ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಹೆಸರುಗಳನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟರು. So it is first ಏನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಕ್ಕಂತಂದ್ರೆ, so it is called as plum pudding ಅಂತಂದ್ರು. ಏನಂತಿದ್ದಕ್ಕೆ plum pudding. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಪ್ಲಮ್ ಪಡ್ಡಿಂಗ್. ಪ್ಲಮ್ ಪಡ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಈಗ ನೀವು ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋದ್ರಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ಸ್ ಹೋದ್ರೆ ಐಸ್ ಕ್ರೀಮ್ ತಿನ್ನೋ ಮುಂದೆ ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲ್ಗಡೆ ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಕೆಲವೊಮ್ಮೆ ಪಿಸ್ತಾ ಬಾದಾಮ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಹಾಕಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರೆ, ಹಿಂಗೆ ಚುಚ್ಚಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಪ್ಲಮ್ ಪಡ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಫುಡ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ಸ್ಗಳಾಗಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ದನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ಸ್ಗಳಾಗಲಿ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯಾವುದೇ ಫುಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಏನದಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ ಆ ಟೈಪ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಪ್ಲಮ್ ಪಡ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿಬೋದು. ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ರೈಸಿನ್ ಪಡ್ಡಿಂಗ್. ರೈಸಿನ್ ಪಡ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿ. ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಮೆಲಾನ್. ವಾಟರ್ ಮೆಲಾನ್ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಮೂರು ಹೆಸರು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋದಕ್ಕೆ. ಒಂದೇದೇನದಲ್ಲ ಪ್ಲಮ್ ಪಡ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತದ್ದು, ಒಣ ದ್ರಾಕ್ಷಿಗಳನ್ನ ನೀವೇನದಲ್ಲ ಅಥವಾ ಪಿಸ್ತಾ ಬಾದಾಮ್ಗಳನ್ನ ನೀವು ಐಸ್ ಕ್ರೀಮ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಚುಚ್ಚಿಟ್ರಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಸೊ ಇದು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಕಾಣಿಸಂಗ ಅಥವಾ ರೆಸಿನ್ ಪಡ್ಡಿ. ಆರ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಮೆಲಾನ್, ವಾಟರ್ ಮೆಲಾನ್ ಕಲ್ಲಂಗಡಿ ಹಣ್ಣು. ಸೊ ಕಲ್ಲಂಗಡಿ ಹಣ್ಣು ಒಳಗೆ ಏನದಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ರೆಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್. ಕಲ್ಲಂಗಡಿ ಹಣ್ಣು ಒಳಗೆ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ರೆಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಏನದ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಬೀಜಗಳು ಸೀಡ್ಸ್, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಬೀಜಗಳು ಸೀಡ್ಸ್. ಸೀಡ್ಸ್ ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್. ಸೊ ಕಲ್ಲಂಗಡಿ ಹಣ್ಣನ್ನು ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಸಾಕು. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಮೆಲಾನ್ ದ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ರೆಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್. And the seeds which are present, the black seeds which are present in the watermelon are called as electrons. So this model that is given by J.J. Thomson. So it is here, that is the important feature of this, that is model, is that the mass of the atom is assumed to be uniformly distributed into the atom. Mass complete in the lab, so it is uniformly distributed. So it is J.J. Thomson's model. ಕಾಮನ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಮೆಲನ್, ಕಲಂಗಡಿ ಹಣ್ಣು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಈಗ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಇನ್ 1898 ಜೆ ಜೆ ಥಾಮ್ಸನ್ 1898 ಜೆ ಜೆ ಥಾಮ್ಸನ್ ಪ್ರಪೋಸಲ್ ದಟ್ J.J. Thomson proposed that, in other words, proposed that an atom possesses a spherical shape. Atom in other words, on the spherical shape of the atom, of radius 10 to minus 10 meter. ಆಮೇಲೆ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಏನದಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅದು ಬರೋದ್ರ ಬಟ್ಟೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 10^-10 ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೀಟರ್. ಇದು 10^-10 ಮೀಟರ್ ಇತ್ತು. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ದ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್. ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ದ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ is uniformly distributed. Positive charge in the complete uniformly distributed again. And the electrons are embedded. Chuchirtavi. Embedded. So it is embedded into it. So it is embedded into it. So it is, they have given that is a different name for this. So it is, so they named it as plum pudding और रेजर पट्टी और वाटरमेलन। लुक हियर स्टूडेंट्स, इट इज अबाउट सो इट इज दिस थॉमसन्स मॉडल। सो इट इज रिमेंबर इन वाटरमेलन द सीड्स आर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एंड द रेड पार्ट इज अ पॉजिटिवली चार्ज पार्ट एंड द होल दट इज वाटरमेलन इज कॉल्ड एज एन एटम। ಇದು ಜೆ ಜೆ ಥಾಮ್ಸನ್ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಸೊ ದ ಹೋಲ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಟಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಅನದರ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮಾಡೆಲ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಟು ದ. ಸೊ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.